Okay, hello. You can probably tell a lot has changed. It's been a number of days since I uploaded an episode, and I'm hoping I can upload this one because I have been playing. I've not been just like slacking off since the 16th of August. I played a couple of times, maybe two or three times, but on each occasion I just didn't manage to progress with the game, so it was a case of, I can't save, I've not really done anything. What did I attempt? Attempted the gun mission. That was frustrating. I managed to get to the AK bit, and I just couldn't get past the first level, and I got my ass kicked by an old woman. It was very, very frustrating. I know why I'm here. I said I'd take Barbara out, and I'm conscious that I've already done this two or three times now, but obviously not saved it. So yeah, just do that quickly. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to head over to Las Venturas and do the next heist mission called Cop Wheels, the one I've been on about where I've got to get like cop bikes on the back of a van, because I know I can do that. And I'm struggling in terms of what's left, and I need to just make sure that I'm playing, at least attempting once a day, provided I've got time. But I feel like I've not recently because I've been doing a lot of other stuff. So I've really been throwing myself into the exercise. I mean, I had mentioned that I've been doing this like high intensity workout stuff as well as yoga. And I finished the 30-day program yesterday on the high intensity stuff, so that was really exciting. So now I'm trying, I started today basically like a 7-day intense abs workout. So yeah, doing that. The yoga I'm keeping up, so I'm actually doing new
CJ, you made me feel
kind
so
of
special.
following new YouTube videos. Because last time,
Congratulations
I
on
tried to do this
completing the
challenge
back.
before, this 30-day yoga challenge, and
We don't get
I
much
ended up
drug-related crime out here in the desert.
failing at about day 24, I think. So I was really close to the end, but yeah, I think it was just one day where I was just feeling a bit run down and then just didn't pick up again. And I really enjoyed it, so I'm really kind of sticking with this now and just making sure that what I'm doing instead is oh dear, hang on, sorry, I lost full control then. At least this with the bike is good practice
Is it a
for
shallow
the
grave
Cop
for it?
Wheels one
Don't
because I'm
worry,
going to be on a
I'll
bike.
be in.
So that's something. But yeah, basically what I'm trying to do now, I'm thinking going forward, I'm going to do 10
We'll pull
minutes
out
of this
some
high
bikes soon,
intensity
yeah?
stuff,
Boss.
which is good for like core strength and just like doing sit-ups in the morning effectively, but a bit more intense. 30 minutes of yoga, which is kind of evening, kind of come down time, although not too late, as I discovered last night. If you try to do yoga, it's about 11 o'clock at night. Your concentration's all over the place. I was a little bit flustered, so yeah, this morning my arms ached a bit. But it helps me sleep, so I try to do it like early evening, normally after dinner. And get my
Oh,
steps
no,
in,
there's
so
shit
doing
on the dust.
10,000 steps, be that running or
Fight your way
walking.
under 9 minutes
I know I've
now.
not done
Every
enough today,
single
I've probably
one.
done about 2,000, but yeah, did I say 10,000? What I meant was
Look at me.
6,500. 10,000 ideally, but
Oh, look
6,500
at
is kind of a
dust.
good, that's an
Let me
hour's
ask you
walk,
something.
really.
Have you ever
I know though
seen
that I
me
was
in
talking to a friend of
action?
mine, we've been doing a
Actually,
lot less walking
genuinely
in
impressed.
lockdown.
That's
He's got a
because they
dog,
never
so
existed.
he's been saying,
Absolutely
he's making himself go out and work time and take the dog out.
I mean,
And I was doing these
imagine they were so
lunchtime kind of,
smart.
head into
Great wall
town or head to
charm.
the country park, and that was
All you
really
have
good
to
and I
do is
enjoyed that.
read and
It's just that I've not
understand.
been doing it
That's a lot of
too,
traction.
well,
Most
this
people don't
week.
even
I
know
wouldn't say
what
recently,
all
I've
you
been doing
do
it this
is
week alone.
unlike
Just on the
ordinary
basis
people.
that the weather's been
All you
rubbish,
do
it's
is
absolutely
read.
pants. Look, I'm in
Read and
jumpers now.
This time
So
around,
yeah, as I say,
it's
a few
different.
things have changed. The weather has changed. It's now fully autumn, it feels like. So I'm wearing sleeves and I'm wearing socks for the first time in donkeys. But also, as you've probably noticed, my hair has changed. I've got a fringe for only the second time
Who
in my
says
life.
rock is dead? No one
The
in this
first time
mob, that's
being
for sure.
after too much drink with my best friend. And we both decided, this is when I was living in Shanghai, that we were going to both go and get something completely different done to our hair. For me, that was a fringe on the basis that in my adult life I had never had a fringe. And this was not a good fringe. It didn't sit properly. I probably mentioned, I mentioned it in an earlier episode, but it basically like changed my face structure and made me look it didn't suit me. It made my face look really long. I was a bit kind of brave, you know, kind of thinking, shall I get a fringe this time? But yeah, my hairdresser, like, you know, knew the kind of, you know, how thick to make it. And so she said, I'm not going to give you a block fringe, which is what I had last time. And I'm really happy with this. And you probably can't see because my hair's tied back. That was clever, Kerry. Also, I've gone significantly darker. And I've gone from kind of blonde to like a very light brown. And I love it. I just think it'll be like a lot more low maintenance, say if, you know, we go through a situation where businesses close again and I can't get my hair done. And I just think, you know, in lockdown, why not try something new? Although, as I discovered last night when I did a TV interview, you have to remember, like, you know, all over again, you know, you have to wear certain makeup and certain clothes when you're doing TV interviews. And I looked a bit, I watched this TV interview back and I just looked a bit washed out.
It's all about the art of deception.
Right. This might take a couple of attempts. I might get it right first time. Basically, I've got a time limit and I have to just nick motorbikes. And because they're police motorbikes, that means that I'm constantly going to have the feds on my arse.
So, we're going to steal ourselves an armored car and respray it so it looks like one of the regular trucks.
What about the police escorts? Whenever they move cash around, they use police motorcycles as outriders.
Exactly what I was thinking.
Also, it's difficult because I've got to get the police off the bikes. That in itself is a challenge. Like, if they're on one, I mean, I could kill one, but if you kill a cop, that means two stars instantly after you, and it just makes everything a bit more difficult.
I'll steal the bikes and get them to you.
Right, so the first one I think will be all right if I get that car. Because what I can do is I can just knock someone off. I don't think the time limit's going to start until I get the first one. Oh no, it started. Okay, so we've got 12 minutes. So this is why I was kind of putting off doing this one, because, you know, 12 minutes, you can only really do two or three attempts before my patience, you know, I try not to play for longer than an hour. So we're going to try and go for the most furthest away one. What goes up must come down. Bullshit. But yeah, as I say, my police are just going to be following me, so that's going to be difficult to shift. Right, there's one here. I'll go for that one. Some of them, as I remember it, are not actually on police bikes, so it should be up, like, there. He's not on one, so. So I can just jump on that. Ooh, okay, right. But as you see, basically, if you're on a police bike, oh, I should have got that star, god damn it. That way it'll... Basically, if I'm on a police bike, the star rating is not going to drop. So, ideally, I need to, as I go, try and lose the cops. Or if I get up to two stars, yeah, basically I might have to try and scope out a star. Oh god. Right, so you can see, so we've done the first one. Good, okay. Right, let's go. Oh! Is that car trying to get onto the truck? Okay, come on. So I've got roughly 3 minutes per bike. So yeah, 12 minutes, so it's not much time, but we'll see how we get on. Also, as you know, it's... Oh, okay, we've lost the police rating now, that's good. Okay, so I might go for this next one, which is up here. But I know there is one where the police literally get on the bike, so I've got to knock them off. And the, you know, I'm in a car, that's okay to do so. Like, there, him. Okay, let's get it. Oh no. Sugar. No. Oh, I might have to shoot him off.
Stay on the runway.
Okay, right, quickly. Oh no, stop getting in the goddamn car, Carl! Alright, I'm gonna go to kill him. God. Right, so as you can see, now I've got two cops after me, which means that I'm just not gonna lose my cop rating. So I'm gonna have to scope out a star now. That's really annoying, but I couldn't do anything. I can't even get out now. Oh my life. But you can see it's obviously a lot slippier trying to get these police bikes when you've got two cops chasing after you. Couldn't be helped though. Could not be helped. Right, okay, where's this truck? Truck's coming. Right, I need to try. God's sake! Oh, I hate this mission. Hate it. God alive as well, I'm having trouble driving. Right, so I'll try and drive up the other side now. Good, okay. Right, I need to lose that star rating now. Oh, sugar. This is just going to make life a lot more. You can see it's just going to make it difficult. Okay, so there was a star that I saw, but I don't know where it is anymore. I know where there is one, it's gonna help, but it's just gonna make it life really difficult. It's just slightly messier. Right, so we've got 7 minutes, which is alright. So be nice if I saw a. Yeah, I'm still got the cops after me. But yeah, you can just see this is just going to make it so much more difficult. If there's one after me, I don't mind, but this is irritating. And I have a feeling that the one here is going to get on the bike. Right, I'm gonna leap on it anyway. Right, well, we're going for it. I'll be glad if I get this mission done, because I really already don't want to repeat it again. It's an annoying mission. Right, okay, we're coming up to, I've got plenty of time as well, which is nice. 6 minutes. So I have got a bit of time in that I could, you know, basically get the star, lose my tail, which will take the heat off. Okay, good. But it doesn't help having cops after me constantly. Oh, it's really fiddly. Sugar. Okay, well, the next one's not far away, which is good. I could probably get there on foot. I can see it. I might actually do it after all that. That would be amazing if I do. And see, he's. Oh, sugar. Why is he driving away? So, two of them obviously drive away, which is annoying. Oh, sugar. Okay. Okay, well, I've got 5 minutes. It's doable. It's annoying, but it's doable. Right, I'm just gonna have to ram him. Really, like, go for it and hope. Good. Okay, better not get back on. Okay, good. And I've still got, God, I've lost a lot of health, but this is good. And I'm straight on the motorway now by the looks of things. Yes, okay, good. Got my hearts racing. But I think I'm gonna do it first time actually, so that's good. I don't think I have to do anything else after this as far as I'm aware. Because as I say, this mission, I've had a few attempts with this one before, so I wasn't expecting it to be perfect, but yes, done. Wow, okay, good. Oh, so that was one that I'd literally been kind of, you know, bracing myself to do.
Okay, that should
and
be
actually wasn't too much of a problem whatsoever. So, yeah, good, good, good. And also, I was getting a bit fed up with just seeing into the country, literally only having one mission, you know, on my kind of list, because I've not really got that many missions left to do in the game now. So, so it'd be good to see a bit of variety and get that percentage up. But yeah, for now, I need to get some food because I lost a lot of health there. It did all get a bit hairy. So let's get to the burger shot. But God, yeah, I mean, literally that was done in 12 minutes, which I wasn't expecting. So got a little bit of time now. I could potentially just save because I'm quite hungry. I might make this, curried cauliflower dish, which doesn't sound thrilling, but is actually quite nice. And when I was at my parents, they've all got into this whole low-carb diet. Like, even my stepdad, who loves, like, sweet things and big carbs. So I feel now, you know, they're going to have flat stomachs than me. You know, it's good, though. Like, you know, if me and my family are all into kind of, you know, stuff like that, we're all eating well. So it's good. And just generally, yeah, I'm eating a lot better now because I have had struggles in lockdown with, you know, eating at the right time, sometimes not eating three meals a day. But no, I mean, literally this week I've been making sure that I'm getting more into, you know, cooking more and being experimental at the same time, just really appreciating my cooking time, so that's been really nice. Anyway, done there. So I'm just thinking, what else could I do? Could go get the jetpack and see if I could get something else. You know, in terms of like, you know, another oyster or whatever. Yeah, the last time I played. Oh, yeah, sorry. So I have played three times because the first time I played, I tried to do the shooting mission. Then I tried to do. I've only played twice. I spent an hour one day trying to find just one more horseshoe. Couldn't find a single horseshoe. There are five left now, and that was extremely frustrating. I mean, I could try again now with the time that I've got left. Seeing as I'm in the area, it would be probably easier to find them than the snapshots. I might go and try and find the snapshots, because they should, in theory, be easier. Whoa! But, I don't know, all these remaining things to find now, it's just so hard! I don't know where they are, any of them. So do what I can, but let's just get to the jetpack and then I'll make a decision once I get there. You know, whether I go to Las Venturas or whether I go over to San Fierro or whether I literally, you know, just go to Tierra Rabata and get a mini helicopter and try and find other things instead, like oysters. But yeah, the jetpack will be. Give me some ideas. I'm thinking horseshoes. Just because I'm lazy and it's there. And this is like literally bare minimum in terms of, you know, anything I need to do. You know, all I do is press a button and move forward. So I can do that for a little bit and then go and save. Which would be good. Yeah, God. I mean, yeah. As I say, now I know that I'm saving. I can tell you a bit more now, because I feel like I've been repeating myself the last few days, like literally trying to tell you, you know, what's been going on, what's new, because it's been literally about 2 weeks now since I last played GTA. No, since I last saved playing GTA. So yeah, I went up to my parents. I got my hair done, which was brilliant for the first time in ages. It was really nice seeing my hairdresser again as well. She's really nice and you know, similar age to me. So, you know, we were talking about shows that we've been watching, you know, spending time in the local area. And my hairdresser's in Stamford as well, which I've not been to in ages. So it was really nice going there again. It's a lovely part of South Lincolnshire, I think. But it's, yeah, it's really scenic and pretty. It's got lovely shops. So we didn't go shopping though, because I think there were like these crazy winds at the time. We didn't really stick around in the centre. But I spent some time with my fat guinea pigs. That was lovely. And yeah, as I say, I've been, you know, experimenting, making some new kind of meals. Nearly finished series two now of Prison Break, because I know I was banging on about that. Also, yeah, speaking to my driving instructor about, you know, kind of, you know, we're now, he's pushing me a bit as a kind of build up to, you know, preparing for a test. So I've been shown the centre, like whereabouts I'd be driving from, and now it's a case of, you know, we're going to get familiar with the roads that I might be taking and such. So all very exciting there. What else is new? God, work's been busy again. Oh God. Yeah, I've been doing a lot of TV this week. Well, just before my haircut and just after. But yeah, a few days off, which was good. Yeah, generally I'm quite happy and well. Don't like that the weather's changed, but at the same time, I think lockdown, I would definitely fully appreciate being in lockdown and working, well, I say lockdown, you know, working from home. When it's cold, I mean, I'm finding now it's, you know, it's harder to get up in the morning already because it's cooler and not as light, and that's going to be a godsend when winter comes, you know, just being able to crawl out of bed. But yeah, I've been doing all sorts, and you know, I'm doing a lot more now in the lead up to the US election, because obviously China has obviously had a huge spat with the US, so it's taken a huge interest in the election and, you know, who might be in power. So yeah, been doing some stuff on that. There's some more going up, like basically there's a live page that's been going up the last, well, went up yesterday, and there's going to be another one today with kind of, you know, content on what you need to know about coverage on the Republican convention and the Democrat convention. So I've been trying to kind of combine the two, because yeah, basically, you know, it's only the Republican one this week, but try and give you a bit of a, you know, what you've missed on the Democrat and how that one was covered. But I'm thinking as well, I might do a bigger piece. I've got some really interesting observations about kind of, you know, how China's covering it. Just really quirky stuff that I don't think you get in an average piece. You know, kind of rather than the straight up geopolitical, you know, predictable trade war, COVID, I can really get into some colourful stuff, like the kind of, you know, the youth kind of discussions taking place about Trump and the perceptions of the administration. And I don't know, I just think I could have some real fun with a piece, so I might consider writing that tomorrow. I'll have to speak to certain members of the team about it. But yeah, doing a lot of that. Coronavirus obviously just carries on, even though China's basically got its coronavirus situation under control for now, which is good. I mean, every time there's a local outbreak, there's a part of me that there's a little part of me that dies inside, which just feels a bit anxious, because obviously I've got friends in China, but also there is a concern that if it gets out of control in China, it will be really hard to contain. I think, you know, China gets a lot of kind of criticism, and obviously it's had a lot in terms of actually just, you know, being the area where this virus was first, you know, known about. But there's not a lot of appreciation for just how well China's containing it, because if it gets to a situation where China has a second wave, and say one that it can't contain, that could be game over for the rest of the world, because, you know, the amount of trade that goes into different countries from China, i.e. the amount of people who do business overseas, Chinese people who could pass the virus on, it could just be disastrous. I mean, you know, we're still in a situation where there's not a vaccine. Hopefully there will be one soon, but the world does not need a second spike. So yeah, China's been very good at just kind of, you know, making sure that when there is an outbreak, people can be traced who are linked to You know, they can basically, it's like a chain effect. So, you know, you find one person who's got it, you identify every single one of their contacts. If another person suddenly gets it from random, they're interrogated until they give all their contacts. If there's even the chance that somebody's got it and they can't be linked, you know, the authorities will find out how they got it, and, you know, they will go to hell and back trying to, you know, basically draw a line under that, so... So these are some of the things that I've been looking at and doing. I feel like there's been some other stuff as well lately. I don't know though, I mean literally, well actually earlier today I was, because I've only just recently got a work computer, I've started downloading my interviews again, because I normally pop them on YouTube, on this page actually, so you know, it's been a, there are some people who follow me who, you know, look for my China interviews. You know, it's a good kind of, you know, background archive of, you know, stories that I've covered, especially with COVID. You know, the way the stories have developed, the way people feel at a certain time. It's a good catalogue there of, like, things. But, yeah, obviously all you've seen recently are me uploading GTA. So I started uploading some more of my interviews again. But I realised that I basically stopped on the 24th of January. I mean, that just tells you how busy it's been for me and how crazy that, like, you know, normally I do it about once a month. And even then, I can only do it once a month because I just don't stop. But, yeah, I mean, I know people who, you know, they do one interview and they want to clip it. And then they're very good at kind of, you know, rolling it out on, you know, reformatting it, turning it into something for TikTok and Instagram, and you know, they keep on plugging it, you know, again and again. I don't have time. Literally, like, you know, I'm just literally, like, you know, once a month I'll just make a list of all the interviews I've done, all the stories, and then I'll basically just, you know, I send them to management and that's it. I'll then slowly, like, you know, try and find some time in the day to just, like, clip them and upload them. But yeah, I mean, January is the last time I did that. And generally, everything that we've done will remain, well, if it, other than TV interviews on World News, which is not accessible in the UK, everything else can be viewed radio-wise within a month. Everything TV-wise can be viewed within a day. So I try to get my TV interviews clipped, like, as soon as possible. Which is why, you know, it's not because I prefer to put those up, it's just on the basis that they'd vanish. Yeah, we have a system where we can access everything, you know, going back years. So now I've got my work laptop again, I can actually access that archive. But I'd already got some that have just been sitting on this desktop that I'd basically, like, one of my last shifts in the office, I'd started clipping these interviews and thinking I'd upload them. And I've just not had time because I've not even been thinking about it. Like, it sounds quite daft, you know, I mean, literally, but, I mean, I do so much work, you know, in terms of range, you know, I think a lot of people work hard, but, you know, I'm constantly churning out lots of different stories, and I'm not very good at self-promotion. I basically just say on Twitter, here's my latest, but, yeah, like, you know, I pop stuff on YouTube when I got it, but yeah, I mean, you know, now I've got time, I could potentially, like, set up a website or something. But yeah, I've got 6 months of archives of endless stories to just, like, clip and go through and such, and it takes time. It's like, you know, because each interview is about three to five minutes, so I'd have to find the time to just, like, stop and find, you know, listen to all these interviews and, you know, get the in and out time, and oh, it's just, yeah, how thrilling I make it sound. I'm sure there's an easier way. I mean, I could just literally, yeah, the system, you can just set the in and out time so I don't have to listen to things. But sometimes it's interesting for me anyway, just to kind of, you know, remind myself, you know, what actually happened at the time. I mean, you know, I've listened back to some of my interviews in the early stages of COVID, and I'm like, God, you know, you can almost, you know, I can put myself back in that situation of what it was like then, you know, how I was feeling, how people were feeling, you know, speaking to friends in China. And it's just sometimes quite interesting just to go over again. So, yeah. But, yeah, I could sell myself a I could sell my stuff a bit better. I don't know though, at the same time, this story has just felt deeply personal to anyone, and I'm less, you know, given the fact that I'm not exactly thrilled about, well, you know, literally racing, wanting to get back to the office and not really feeling like, you know, I'm missing out on much, because I know there have been some people who've been chomping at the bit who feel like they've got to climb the ladder, and I'm just like, yeah, whatevs. just things are good. So I've not got too many worries about, you know, my career development or anything. I feel like this story, it's just been a kind of, it's been more important to me at the time just to tell those stories. And, you know, I'm glad that I can tell them. And that I'm trusted to tell them. Right, well, I've had a look around. I've still not seen any. Not that I was expecting to see one jump out of me straight away, but I'm trying to cover territory that I don't think I've been yet. I'm still kind of going under these tunnels in the expectation that I might see one. Because I did mention when I did this cop mission that, as I remembered it, I thought I saw some, you know, as you're chasing that truck, but I didn't see any because I seemed to do it actually quite swiftly, the mission. So, yeah, you know, that's out. What's that guy doing? He's gone now. That was a bit random. Yeah, so I might actually just... Oh, and that general store sign is, like, tripping out. But, yeah, I might actually just save quite quickly because I'm quite hungry and I don't want a situation last night where I ended up doing yoga at 11 o'clock because, well, I did TV and I was meant to be on a bit earlier, but I always feel a bit... Well, not always, but sometimes it feels like, you know, you've not really signed off for the day. So it feels a bit weird to just, like... you know, have a meal and settle down. I prefer to, like, you know, my evening meal, really kind of chill out, watch some TV and really kind of, you know, kind of sets me up for the evening. But I ended up doing this quite late, so I was like, okay, I'll have dinner quite late. I'm used to that recently. But then it got pushed back because of some breaking news, so I ended up doing it a lot later. And had I done my high intensity? I think I'd done the high intensity stuff beforehand, yeah. But... something else happened. Oh yeah, I basically was determined to clip it and to just kind of, you know, start as I'm going on now and be a bit more proactive in not letting these clips pile up, but actually just, you know, get the interview and clip it there and then. And again, I've just, you know, forgotten just how much time this takes, so messed around doing that. And just before I knew it, it just got really late. So yeah, then I had dinner, that took forever. So yeah, I ended up doing yoga at 11 o'clock at night. And it was meant to be easier, I thought. I mean, it was with a woman who was near her 60s. And Tim Senesay, I think his surname is, Yoga with Tim, basically, was saying, you know, this is a woman who, you know, basically some of the classes I'd seen him with people who'd been doing yoga for years, a lot of these young women and such. And he said in the early challenge last year, because he'd done the same kind of challenge the year before, he'd had this woman on, he'd invited her back, and people really kind of, you know, connected with the fact that she wasn't this kind of yoga bunny, you know, early 20s, thin stomach, you know, she was basically, you know, had a figure that a lot of people could kind of relate to and such. But my God, Jesus Christ, like, you know, I was following what he was saying, and I felt like it was the toughest yet, and I don't know whether it was because of the time of night I was doing it, or... whether it was too soon after dinner, or whether I'm just, you know, I don't think I'm unfair. I think I've been, you know, making sure that I keep up with this yoga. But I just found that really, really goddamn hard. And it might have been that I'm just kind of attuning myself rather than, you know, because the closer I'm getting now to the end of the 30-day challenge, you know, he's focusing less on you learning the moves and more on you kind of, you know, perfecting the moves. So it might be that I'm just suddenly going, oh yeah, okay, actually I might have been doing that one wrong, and now I'm putting my limbs in the right place, and holy, holy moly, this is actually quite painful. So yeah, it might have been that. Welding and weddings. Right, I don't think I've seen that before, but no horseshoe, so no luck there. Oh, I've not seen any, no. But yeah, what else to tell you? God, I don't know. Oh, my progress with Millie's dropped. Yeah, as I say, things are just generally good. Work is, you know, just carry on as usual. It's quite laid back, which is good. I just generally feel quite calm and quite kind of, you know, I've kind of got into the motion of going through the motions of, you know, I know what I've got to do and such. I think it's been very telling. I know that there's a lot of people who are suddenly a lot more kind of panicked, even though they've got work, just kind of, I think some people are feeling more under pressure to kind of, you know, either carve out a niche for themselves, or yeah, it might just be like, you know, personal development. A lot of people are kind of more focused about that now in a COVID era. You know, do they want to be doing this? Are they happy? Could they be doing something else? Could they be, some people are still not adjusting to this, you know, they're still kind of thinking that they'd rather be in an office environment, whereas I have generally, I think, you know, I've kind of got myself to a, I've got some structure in my day, I'm doing daily exercise, I'm eating well, God, I sound like a riot, you know, but yeah, I mean, the next thing I'm kind of focusing on is getting my bathroom done, and I might have a few days off soon just to, I don't know what I'll do, maybe just a bit of shopping and, you know, focus again on getting some nice things for my house, because I've not done that recently. I feel like all I've been doing is internet shopping, but I might just have a nice, you know, a couple of days and just kind of, you know, where I take it easy. Just wander around the area, just chill out, be nice. That's my phone. Oh, it's just an email. Stop looking a bit. Anyway, I'm not having much luck with finding those remaining four horseshoes. Crawling around here again. I'm surprised I didn't see one here, because that struck me as potential area where there could be one, but doesn't look like it. I don't think you can get into that structure as well. I know I keep seeing it, but I don't think it's, there's a way in, I think. Look. Oh, also, yeah, I watched a new program recently. While I was at my parents', we decided to watch White Gold, which is, it's got two of the guys from The Inbetweeners in. And that was really funny. I mean, literally, you know, because I love my 80s stuff. It's full of 80s music. It's set in the 1980s, and it's about these kind of sleazy double glazing salesmen. And it was just really fun. I mean, I've only watched the first series so far, but I really enjoyed that. So, yeah, watched that at my parents', watched all of the first series. So that was good. That's it really. Don't know what's new. But yeah, I've been thinking might do some kind of, you know, new challenges or something soon. Not gaming though, because I know that there's been a part of me that's been like, oh, I might play this again, I might do this. But I know when I get to that stage, it's because I'm in a bit of a gridlock with the game. And it's good that I've done this mission, because that will spur me on, as opposed to making me think, might try something else for a bit, and just kind of, you know, send me in the direction of potentially bailing after 140 uploads, whereas I need to just, you know, persevere and make sure that I'm sticking to, you know, trying to complete this. Even if I'm failing each day, and that's going to happen a lot now in the lead up, unless I can find some of these extras, you know, just at least I'm trying, because I need to make sure that I'm familiar with the controls and the city and everything, where everything is, and, you know, just kind of make sure that I'm on it. I'll have to try Freefall soon, but not today. I've done my mission, I'm pleased about that. So that's another one out of the way. You can tick it off, and it'll also mean my percentage increases. So I'm pleased about that. But yeah, no, I think I'm going to save now, because I've had a look. And as I say, last time I played, I had a good search for an hour. So it's not like I've not already had a huge look around here. I just don't know where they could be. I'll have a look south again. Just at least, because I know there's a lot of houses around here. But oh, I'm struggling now at this, yeah, at this point. It's all these little balconies as well. I mean, it could literally be under one of these. And these, like, bush shelters as well. I just feel like I've been here. I feel like I've been everywhere, though, you know, and it's, this is where they just spring out normally, so. Have a quick look. But, yeah, I'm basically, I'm getting ready to go and cook some food and then, yeah, watch an episode of Prison Break and get my yoga done in the evening. And then hopefully settle down for an early night, because I've been going to bed way too late recently. And possibly, I'm looking for, I need like a few new light fittings, so I might have a look. I just know that I've been kind of on hold, knowing that, you know, new season stuff's coming in, so I'm looking at a lot of the same stuff at the moment. Oh god, I've not seen any of these. I hope there's not going to be some in just this kind of, you know, redundant desert land. But you never know. Just, I don't seem to be having any luck anywhere else. No, 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 no! Ugh. All these little hidey holes. Okay. Right, I think I'm gonna save. I'm really hungry. And I'll be starving by the end of this. Oh, so, yeah. Now's the time. I had a look. We came, we saw. And for now, we conquered. Weird, this is a different construction site. I'll just have a look here again. Because there was a part of me that, again, I think this was a different GTA game, but there was a part of me that wondered if they were in these pipes. Not seeing any here, but I'll just have a look. Because I don't think I've looked around here too closely. So you never know, you never, never know. And I'm just going to reiterate again, I've not done any cheating in terms of these. Like, I have no idea where they're going to be. It's just a question of if I find them, I find them. But, you know, it's something that I could just tick off the list if I, you know, did kind of just follow a crib sheet and found them all in order, but I don't mind with this. It's quite fun when you find a new, like, tag and the extras. Right, yeah, we've been here. That's where I saw the minigun. I mean, I'm looking around here, you know, this construction, and I'm not seeing anything flashing. Right, I'm admitting defeat. I'm starving, so let's jack it in. Let's find my safe house. I think there's one roughly around here. I don't know that I'm far off it saying, you know, you are starting to lose weight, but yeah, for now, we'll call it a day. There we go. Oops, okay. When that happens, it means I might get it when I come back to play. Okay, let's see where we're at. There we are, 88.24. Excellent, 88%. Right, so I've only got 12% left to go now. which is good. So I managed to get myself that 1% higher by doing that mission. But yeah, it's getting really difficult now. So it'll be a case of, you know, I'll upload when I can, but we'll see. I'll keep trying and hopefully get closer and closer. But for now, I'm happy with that. So I'll see you guys later.